How are
Chef,
you, brother?
Adob,
The chef.
you would be well. I have a question that I am an ex-railway, and you might be familiar with the term railway. In the subcontinent, there are about many followers of Amar Raza Khan, and they have quite strange ideas, beliefs, and ideas like the prophet is alive and sort of. But the issue is, when I was a railway, I made a promise to the prophet to do something good and to avoid some evil, but unfortunately I broke the promise. So now I want to ask that is there any expiation that I have to pay, or what to do now?
Okay, I got your question, Brother Dasher. And before I answer the question, I'd like to share with you a very important fact, which is the Almighty Allah said, my servant will never do anything to make me love him dearer to me than fulfilling what I have ordered him to do. And he said, and my servant will continue to draw nearer to me through offering the voluntary acts of worship until I love him. And in Surah Al Imran, chapter number 3, ayah number 31, the Almighty Allah said, قُلْ إِن كُنتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. So according to this ayah, which many of the Mufassirin and the scholars called it the ayah of the test, Allah tested the true faith of those who claim to be believers. If you truly love Allah, then you gotta prove your love to Allah through following me strictly. So, if I ask you, did it say anywhere in the Quran that Prophet Muhammad is dead or he will die? Yes, there are many verses. Take for instance, Allah the Almighty said, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ ثم إنكم يوم القيامة عند ربكم تختصمون. So النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is dead. He's physically dead. He's not half dead. He's not three quarters dead and one quarter alive. No, he is fully dead. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forbidden the earth again is touching his body. So his body does not decay nor decompose. He smells good as the same day that he was buried. Also in the hadith, we know that when I'm sitting here and I say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, there are angels who convey my salam to the Prophet. So Allah will give him the sunnah to say, wa alaykum as-salam. But which kind of soul, which kind of life, just to reply to the salam? So is he alive? Does he pray? Does he need provision? None of that is true. So, yes, I remember. Sometimes when I used to give the khutbah in some masajid in Houston, Texas, some people will stand up when I say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Then they claim that because the Prophet has arrived. This is all not true, 100%. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will never leave his grave until the day of judgment. And he will be the first person to come out of the grave on the day of judgment. The idea that some people see him physically and he appears with them and he sits with them, all of that is extreme. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never ever said anything like that. We truly love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but we do not consider him was created from nur. He's a nur in a sense that he's shedding light in our life, teaching us the Quran and the hikmah. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was created like Adam, like Isa, he's one of the children of Adam. And the first creation was not Muhammad at all. The first creation of the human beings was Adam alayhi salam. So some of these, you know, misinformations which are being circulated, you need to ask. Ask your dad, your mom, your uncles, where did you get this from? And be careful. If one day I tell you otherwise, question me. Where did you get this from? Is it in the Quran? Is it in any hadith? If I say, but my sheikh said, then I'm a liar. It must be provided with sound references because this is pertaining to the unseen al-ghayb. Secondly, You said you've made a promise to the Prophet ﷺ and you're not able to fulfill it. You don't make a promise to the Prophet. You don't. Because here you're talking about nazr. And a nazr or the vow, you make a promise only with Allah. Like you said, oh Allah, I'm going to pray every night two rakahs. Muhammad ﷺ has nothing to do with that. Like you don't say, oh Prophet Muhammad, I'm going to pray for you two rakahs. None of that is accepted, not only valid. It's not even valid, it's not accepted. We say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ إِهْدِنَا الصَّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. It is only you whom we worship. It is only you whom we seek his help. مَنْ نَذَرَ أَنْ يُطِيعَ اللَّهَ فَلْيُطِعْ. So if you have made a vow, for instance, you say, oh Allah, I will not smoke after today. لِلَّهِ عَلَيَّ. You don't say, oh Prophet Muhammad, I promise you I will not smoke. That's not nazr. Okay? Because this is between you and Allah. So if you fail to fulfill what you promised to do, then there is a kafara, an expiation, which is similar to the ransom and the expiation of the oath. A person is not able to fulfill it. ولكن يؤاخذكم بما عقدتم الأيمان فكفارته إطعام 10 مساكين من أوسط ما تطعمون أهليكم أو كسوتهم. To feed 10 poor people one meal, or to buy an outfit for 10 poor people, and in case that you cannot afford that financially, then fast for 3 days.